Hey guys, Jarell here, GreyWolf TV, back with our episodes of Star Trek Picard. This is going to be episode 4. Previously, in episode 3, Darji's sister was attempting to have a conversation with one of the Romulans that was originally assimilated on the Borg reclamation ship, who has said she recognises her from tomorrow, whatever that means, and has called her the Destroyer. I have no clue what that means, but I guess we'll find out at some point. And her mentioning that these were the only Romulans that were ever assimilated, which is incorrect. In the meantime, Picard's trip was temporarily slowed down by, I believe, sending more Romulan biker dudes to try and stop him. And at the same time, the Doctor turned up, shot one of them in the back, and then professed that she's coming with him, much to the annoyance of Raffi, who has said she doesn't have any security clearance and she didn't have time to run any on her. I do believe she could be correct with that, and this may be a plant. I guess time will only tell. So Picard has his crew ready. Besides himself, he has Raffi, who apparently is only on board to hitch a ride to Freecloud, which sounds like an online storage service where you might store your files. His cliched captain, who thinks he's Han Solo. I guess we're just going to go and find out what happens next. So, let's go find out. This is episode 4.
Though wanting in practice, had a profound theory, redoubled his agility. Jussac, anxious to put an end to this.
I'm busy, Raffi.
What do you mean, sense of attack, Mars?
This is when it all goes to shit.
What will this mean for our mission? Will it continue?
Of course, it must. Tell Elnor I'm sorry we didn't finish our fencing lesson, but, well, I'll be back soon.
Picard, ready for transport.
You know what? Fine.
Let's go to Vashti. Check out that big statue of you. I mean, they must have put up at least one.
If they did, somebody's probably stolen it by now. Kira's sector's sketchy nowadays. Serious power vacuum. Cantor got hold of an antique bird of prey somewhere and has been running wild from Vashti to Dimanta.
They are not assassins and you can't hire them.
The Kawat Malat have to choose you.
Romulan warrior nuns.
That's a real thing?
Some Kawat Malat.
On Vashti alone, they helped Raffi and me relocate more than a quarter of a million refugees.
Losing Daj has you thinking about Vashti and the kid.
Elnor.
Okay.
I may never pass this way again.
Dolantru. Kawat Milat.
Dolantru. You got old, Admiral Picard.
You didn't.
Yeah.
I remind you, this is a house of truce.
Somebody ID'd him. He's blowing up on personal comm traffic down there.
No, not now, Raffi. I need more time.
These aren't love letters, JL. There's a lot of anger. We're about to get a visit from Kar Kantar.
Well, you do what you have to do, and I need more time.
Picard out.
Do the Kawat Milat still bind their blades to a singular cause?
If the cause is judged worthy.
I always imagined that you had found a suitable place for him.
So many things we imagined back then never came to be.
Yeah, but it's not just Elnor. It's everything here. The poverty, the degradation.
I allowed the perfect to become the enemy of the good.
You have not spoken of your purpose yet. I infer that you have come to obtain the services of a Kalan Kakai. Why?
I am taking on the Tal Shiar alone.
He does not belong here. Once the evacuation ended, we simply never found a better home for him.
So he really is a Kawat Milat?
No. And as a man, he never can be. But he is open-hearted. And apart from this display of the reticence you always seem to inspire in him, forthright. And his fighting skills are truly formidable.
When you bind your sword to a cause, is there some kind of protocol, ritual? Do I go on my knees, or I do hope not. Between the two of us, my knees are not what they used to be.
You tell a story, I listen.
And one of them, her name was Daj, was murdered in front of me. The other one, I believe, is in serious danger, and I have to find her before the Tal Shiar do.
The Tal Shiar?
Yes.
And this other sister, is she an android?
Mm-hmm.
You told me stories about Data. He had an orange cat named Spot.
That's right.
He did.
Why do you need me?
Because I'm an old man and you're a young one, and you're strong. Zani told me that you are one of the best fighters that she has ever seen. Will you come with me? Will you bind your sword to my quest?
Now that you have use for me? Now that I have value to you?
Jean-Luc?
I had the honor of being present the day you addressed the Hall of State, the very embodiment of Starfleet, the great Saint Picard.
Senator.
I found it extremely moving. I was very touched. When you returned, you brought the ships. Those great big Wallenberg class transports.
We had so little time. There were so many of you to save.
And so little to be expected from Starfleet.
I did everything I could.
And then you gave up. You took advantage of us at the very moment where we doubted ourselves, enticed us with your empty promises.
No.
Come on.
No.
Please, my friend. Choose to live.
You're dead.
Ranveha strujat Picard Trakalankai. Ijani dorza ti. Ime fel dordar.
Picard, ready for transport.
The Tangalang is no match for a disruptor system boy.
Yes, now! That man did not deserve to die. Yeah. I will benefit by your skill and your courage, but if you bind yourself to my cause, I will tell you when to fight and when to refrain. Is that understood?
Yes.
What made you decide to bind yourself to my cause?
It met the requirements for worthiness.
What is the requirement for worthiness?
A Galankai will only bind herself, himself, to a lost cause.
Oh, it's Cantor! Near miss. Hold on.
Just get us the hell out of here.
Beam over. His ship's breaking up.
Shields are failing.
Raffi, beam him in directly here.
Do it.
Got him.
Oh, you've got to be kidding me.
7 of 9.
You owe me a ship, Picard.
Right, that was episode 4, and I am more confused than ever. Although I did like the fact that it was 7 of 9 at the end. I didn't know that was coming. This seems to be the systematic breakdown of Picard realizing for the last 18 years all of his mistakes and things that he should have done, things that he should have put right. And him now realizing that this one last mission is for him to try to at least patch as much as he can in his own mind and repair what he can. But that has just proved, going back to that planet, how much things have changed and how they all went catastrophically wrong. I didn't expect the young boy to actually take him up on his offer. But as you said, that the actual causes that they take on is lost causes. So that's why he's joined him. I still didn't appreciate the F-bomb in the episode, especially as the context that it was used in was absolutely completely not necessary. But I digress. I shall leave it alone. Leave it for other people to decide on that. So this was a stopgap episode for Picard to come to terms with his past with these people and to pick this guy up on the way before he heads towards Freecloud and to try to find Bruce Malix. Whilst at the same time, by the looks of things now, he has also picked up 7 of 9, which could possibly come in very handy if things started getting complicated with this thing with the Borg ship as well. I have still no clue what is going on with Darji's sister. I still don't know a damn name. And what she's trying to get to and what this destroyer thing is. Someone said in the comments that it was something to do with referencing Star Trek Discovery, in which case I haven't got a clue because I have not watched that and I refuse to watch that because I'm not interested in that show in the slightest. So I hope they don't go too that far down that route where you need to have at least seen that or know some of the show's storyline for it to tie in. I hope they don't do that. I hope they don't start branching off for you to know part of another show. I want them to keep it strictly to Picard and this canon universe, not to Discovery. We'll just have to wait and see. So, I'll be honest, that was the least annoying episode so far because I have been worried that this was starting to go a lot in the wrong direction. And that's given us quite a bit of backstory there as well as to what happened after the synths attacked Mars and the devastation that it caused for a lot of the refugees and a lot of the Romulans that Picard was trying to help and what he was trying to do at the time. And he was in an impossible situation because when it showed that flashback as to what he was trying to do at the time, and then he gets that call from Raffi saying that they've just attacked, what more was he meant to do at that point? And we've had previously, in I think it was the last episode, him saying, how am I supposed, I can't get a fleet together of ships without Starfleet's help. It's all over. There's nothing more I can do now. I noticed Raffi seems to be over her drug problem very quickly in that episode and is no longer needing the thing, but there you go. Right, that was episode 4. We will be back with episode 5 as soon as it releases next week, guys. So until then, thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to hit the subscribe and by all means post your comments below. Give me your take on the episode and I will see you for the next one very soon. Until then, thanks for watching. Take care.